it is used for calling superclass constructor, or it is used to assess those member of superclass that are hidden by the members of subclass. To call the constructor of immediate superclass to assess the members of immediate superclass. So this is all inheritance. Two topics are covered here, and multi-level inheritance. So if we say about the multi-level inheritance, so multi-level inheritance is when the object of subclass is created and the constructor of subclass is called, which in turn call the constructor of its immediate superclass. If we take a case of multi-level inheritance where class B inherits from class A and class C inherits from class B, you can see the output of the example program in our coming videos. There is a method overriding. So redefining inherited method in subclass in redefinition declaration should be identical code, may be different. Is like having another version of same product, can be used to add more functionality to a method. Sometimes class represent an abstract concept. In this case, it becomes essential to override methods derived class of abstract class. So here is a topic we can cover here, final keyword. Why we are using final keyword? To declare the constant variable, to prevent a method to be overridden, to declare a method as final, to prevent a class to be inherited, or to declare a class as final. If we declare the constant variable or by the final keyword, then we can't override or inherit that class. An abstract, and any abstract class is used to provide a common interface to different classes derived from it. All the derived classes override methods of abstract class with the same declaration. Abstract class has to group several. So now the topic come here is polymorphism. What is polymorphism? Polymorphism is where the program have same name, but is this capability of method to do different things based on the object through which it is invoked. So object is acting upon. For example, method find area will work definitely for circle object and triangle object. So in Java, the type or actual object always determine method calls object reference type doesn't play any role. So we already use two types of polymorphism, is overloading and overriding. So in the current topic, dynamic method binding is a very important. It always come in Java interview questions. Dynamic method binding. Java uses dynamic method dispatch mechanism to decide at runtime which overridden function will be invoked. So dynamic method dispatch mechanism is important because it is used to implement runtime polymorphism in Java. Java uses the principle a superclass object can refer to a subclass object to resolve calls to overridden method at runtime. If a superclass has method that is overridden by its subclasses, then the different version of the overridden method are invoked or executed with the help of superclass reference variable. Assume that there are three subclasses, cricket player, hockey player and football. So that derived from player abstract class are defined, with each subclass has its own play method. So we can see with the examples in the program, because by theory you can't get anything. So let's discuss about final keyword again. Final keyword is, these are very important topics, because that's why I'm repeating again. So the final keyword is used for three purposes: making constants, preventing method to overridden, and preventing a class to be inherited. Final keyword is a way of marking a variable as read only. Its value is set at once and then cannot be changed. For example, if year is declared as final int year 2005, variable year will be counted containing value 2005, cannot take any other value afterwards. So the final keyword can also be applied to method with similar semantics. So the definition will not change. You cannot override the final method in subclasses. This means definition is the final one. You should define a method final when you are concerned that a subclass may accidentally deliberately redefine the method override. If you want to prevent a class to be inherited, apply the final keyword to an entire class definition. For example, if we use final class personal and inside we mention the data members and member functions. So if you try to inherit class personal, so the class personal extend personal, so it will be illegal. You cannot derive from personal class since it's a final class. Okay, so I think we covered all topics or anything left. So here is, I think we covered all topics. So this is also an example of SS specifier. So here is this. So this is also a program of SS specifier. Here we are using private, and inheritance is also using here. Okay. Let's go to another program. This is also using SS specifier. Here's a protected tuple and this. And this is the dispatch. We are discussing about the dispatch. No? So public class dispatch and call me and this. So very important topic, dispatch. So you can see, go with this example and understand better. So let's discuss about the package in with one definition, and we will do a program. Or we already using package in our programs. So Java program creates a package to partition a classes. Partitioning of classes helps in the managing the program. So the package statement is used to define the space to store classes. In Java, you can write your own package. Writing package is just like you write any other Java program. You just have to take care of some points during writing packages which are given. There must be not more than one public class per file. All files in the package must named name of class.java, where name of class is the name of single public class in the file. The very first statement in each file in the package before any import statement or anything, put the statement package my package name. So that's why if we are running the program, it's showing error because we are using here package, or these all programs are can be run without package. If we run these program outside the package, they will run okay and showing you output, because I'm using package from starting, so it will be difficult to make one new program in another package. Or in package, using package is very secure, so you can define package for your own program. Package or package name, this statement will create a package of this name and package name. You have always to do one thing, that is dot class files created for classes and package. Let us say package, package name must be stored in a directory name package name. In other words, you can say that the directory name must exactly match the package name. You can also create a hierarchy of packages. To do this, you have to create packages by separating them using period dot. Generally a multi-level package statement look like we will do this. I'm just explaining the you definition of package, and practically we will do in our coming videos. Or you already knew about the class path we mentioned in our starting videos, 1 or 2, 2, 3 video number, I don't know now. So okay, so package naming. While package naming, you have to take care of many things. This topic is very big, so I don't want to take now this topic. And we already discussed the stack. And let's see any topic left. Overloading done, overloading constructor, objectives, parameter, recursion. I think we covered all topics. Abstract class, polymorphs, final keyword. And this is private inheritance, super keyword. Let's see one more program on these topics. Few programs if we have. You can use like this superclass and run your program. I'm finding the program of, let's see. You can check the Fibonacci.java program on GitHub, and I didn't discuss about the Fibonacci, so let's see.